So how are we preparing the students for facing volatility, uncertainty and complexity? Is first of all telling them that the world is indeed a VUCA world, that's number one. And secondly, telling them that in order to deal with this world, first of all, they need to be multidisciplinary, that they cannot be just one-trick ponies. And second, they need to build certain skills and attributes which are not necessarily only functional skills. They need to become good in interpersonal skills, behavioral skills, negotiation skills, etc. And also some of the other behavioral attributes like how to handle stress, how to sort of be self-aware. So we are also introducing courses on these aspects that will prepare them well to handle the VUCA world. And then lastly, you must keep yourself, they must keep themselves abreast of global history and global events. So we have gotten them exposed to international journals and newspapers and also articles and also to different books, etc., so that they become aware of what is possible, what could likely happen, what could go wrong, what could go right, etc. So you will not be able to understand the present or the future unless you knew the past. So the new age, for example, data analytics and big data is a very important aspect of the new age demands in the marketplace. So we have a certificate program which is running for the second year in a row, where we teach not only our students but also industry participants who want to change over to a new career. So data science, business analytics and big data are the new courses we have introduced. And now going forward in the next batch which joins in July 2019, they will do a compulsory course on design thinking. In fact, we are also going to train our faculty in various aspects of design thinking. And then the other way of preparing the students for the new age demands is actually to put them through immersion exercise. The first immersion exercise we are doing is to sort of give them a capstone simulation course in the fourth term, that is the first term of second year. When they come back from the summer placement, they will do this capstone simulation course, which forces them to integrate all the skills and concepts they learned in the first year and make business decisions. The IFMR Graduate School of Business is actively beginning to look at the various processes and system requirements that are needed to win international accreditations. They are important because they are a signal of quality which many institutions, including recruiters, look for, so that they know that there are certain minimum standards and processes that are followed in the business school, both with respect to teaching and also with respect to research and also with respect to student affairs, etc. So in some sense, it gives all external stakeholders a good benchmark for against which they can evaluate the IFMR Graduate School of Business. So these stamps of approval are necessary, and of course one has to do more than what accreditation processes require, because to excel in business education is not just a matter of winning accreditations and getting them renewed, but also to go beyond what accreditation processes require and be able to prepare our students to face the 21st century world. That is what we are focused on. But accreditation and other rankings are important milestones in that journey, and that is how we view them. Rankings should be viewed as incidental or consequential outcomes arising out of certain things that we do. So we need to keep focused on admission processes, placement, the strength of the faculty, the uniqueness and the depth and the breadth of the courses that we teach, our MDP offerings, management development program offerings, etc. So when we do all these things well, then rankings will automatically follow. So it's easier to start with the cons first, because you simply the distance from Chennai and the lack of school facilities for children. Therefore, faculty members who have school-going children are reluctant to locate here. They commute from Chennai, and that kind of makes it difficult for them to be in constant touch with the students. So that is the con part of it. And of course, you can't call this an educational hub or an enclave, which it may become down the road, but right now it is not. It's more of an industrial enclave. And therefore, we might be just one of the rare educational institutions at this point in time, because if you have a hub, educational hub, then the extent of interaction, academic synergies, and intellectual vibrancy that occurs automatically, that is not there yet, but it could still come. And then there are, of course, issues with the infrastructure, such as landline telephones or internet connectivity, which are all constantly improving. I'm sure what I hear from people who have been here since 2014 is that things are far better than they were 5 years ago for the IFMR business school staff and students, etc. So, but the pro is, I think the pros vastly outnumber the cons and also outweigh the cons, because this kind of industrial hub and the opportunity to interact with decision makers across various sectors, across various companies, isn't easily available to business school students elsewhere. And I think, and second, they come from multiple countries. I understand that 27 countries are represented here. In that sense, the students get an opportunity to see not only manufacturing enterprises in action, but also they are multinational in nature. And the third thing I would say is, one of the nice things about some of the employers here is that most of them employ women. So I think students become sensitized to issues such as gender diversity, women in the workforce, productivity of companies that employ women versus men, etc. All these kinds of issues also, they become aware and they can actually process them and arrive at better conclusions, which will also make them better decision makers. So in that sense, students get a tremendous opportunity to be immersed in real life situations. In fact, some companies have only 100% women in their workforce here, Foxconn, for example. And then Mondelez, the Cadbury maker, employs more than 50% women. So I think these are all opportunities that I don't think business schools that are not located in a place like Sri City would get. So, how are we preparing the students for facing volatility, uncertainty, and complexity is, first of all, telling them that the world is indeed a VUCA world. That's number one. And secondly, telling them that in order to deal with this world, first of all, they need to be multidisciplinary, that they cannot be just one-trick ponies. And second, they need to build certain skills and attributes which are not necessarily only functional skills. They need to become good in interpersonal skills, behavioral skills, negotiation skills, etc. And also some of the other behavioral attributes like how to handle stress, how to sort of be self-aware. So we are also introducing courses on these aspects that will prepare them well to handle the VUCA world. And then lastly, they must keep themselves abreast of global history and global events. So we have gotten them exposed to international journals and newspapers and also articles and also to different books, etc., so that they become aware of what is possible, what could likely happen, what could go wrong, what could go right, etc. So you will not be able to understand the present or the future unless you knew the past. So the new age, for example, data analytics and big data is a very important aspect of the new age demands in the marketplace. So we have a certificate program which is running for the second year in a row, where we teach not only our students but also industry participants who want to change over to a new career. So data science, business analytics, and big data are the new courses we have introduced. And now going forward in the next batch, which joins in July 2019, they will do a compulsory course on design thinking. In fact, we're also going to train our faculty in various aspects of design thinking. And then the other way of preparing the students for the new age demands is actually to put them through immersion exercise. The first immersion exercise we are doing is to sort of give them a capstone simulation course in the fourth term, that is the first term of second year. When they come back from the summer placement, they will do this capstone simulation course, which forces them to integrate all the skills and concepts they learned in the first year and make business decisions. The IFMR Graduate School of Business is actively beginning to look at the various processes and system requirements that are needed to win international accreditations. They are important because they are a signal of quality which many institutions, including recruiters, look for, so that they know that there are certain minimum standards and processes that are followed in the business school, both with respect to teaching and also with respect to research, and also with respect to student affairs, etc. So in some sense, it gives all external stakeholders a good benchmark for against which they can evaluate the IFMR Graduate School of Business. So these stamps of approval are necessary, and of course one has to do more than what accreditation processes require, because to excel in business education is not just a matter of winning accreditations and getting them renewed, but also to go beyond what accreditation processes require and be able to prepare our students to face the 21st century world. That is what we are focused on. But accreditation and other rankings are important milestones in that journey, and that is how we view them. Rankings should be viewed as incidental or consequential outcomes arising out of certain things that we do. So we need to keep focused on admission processes, placement, the strength of the faculty, the uniqueness and the depth and the breadth of the courses that we teach, our MDP offerings, management development program offerings, etc. So when we do all these things well, then rankings will automatically follow. It's easier to start with the cons first, because you simply the distance from Chennai and the lack of school facilities for children. Therefore, faculty members who have school-going children are reluctant to locate here. They commute from Chennai, and that kind of makes it difficult for them to be in constant touch with the students. So that is the con part of it. And of course, you can't call this an educational hub or an enclave, which it may become down the road, but right now it is not. It's more of an industrial enclave. And therefore, we might be just one of the rare educational institutions at this point in time, because if you have a hub, educational hub, then the extent of interaction, academic synergies, and intellectual vibrancy that occurs automatically, that is not there yet, but it could still come. And then there are, of course, issues with the infrastructure, such as landline telephones or internet connectivity, which are all constantly improving. I'm sure what I hear from people who have been here since 2014 is that things are far better than they were 5 years ago for the IFMR business school staff and students, etc. So, but the pro is, I think the pros vastly outnumber the cons and also outweigh the cons, because this kind of industrial hub and the opportunity to interact with decision makers across various sectors, across various companies, isn't easily available to business school students elsewhere. And I think, second, they come from multiple countries. I understand that 27 countries are represented here. In that sense, the students get an opportunity to see not only manufacturing enterprises in action, but also they are multinational in nature. And the third thing I would say is, one of the nice things about some of the employers here is that most of them employ women. So I think students become sensitized to issues such as gender diversity, women in the workforce, productivity of companies that employ women versus men, etc. All these kinds of issues also, they become aware, and they can actually process them and arrive at better conclusions, which will also make them better decision makers. So in that sense, students get a tremendous opportunity to be immersed in real life situations. In fact, some companies have only 100% women in their workforce here, Foxconn, for example. And then Mondelez, the Cadbury maker, employs more than 50% women. So I think these are all opportunities that I don't think business schools that are not located in a place like Sri City would get. So,